development meeting conference at 7:01 p.m. on Monday, March 7th. I don't know if you see later than that.
Council Jerky.
Present.
Council Lepala.
Present.
Council Bass.
Present.
Council Stanton.
Present.
Council Harris.
Present.
All present. Approval of the minutes from February 22nd, 2022.
Move to approve.
Council Bass has a motion to approve the minutes from February 22nd, 2022. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
All opposed? The ayes have it. Is anybody reporting this meeting?
Chris Gamble, please. Thank you.
Could you state your address for the record?
34 Francis Street.
Welcome. Council Lepala.
Take the resolution recording of the council meeting.
Council Lepala makes a motion to take recording all public meetings off the table. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
All opposed? The ayes have it. Council Lepala.
Motion here from all opposition members.
Council Lepala makes a motion here from all opposition members. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
The ayes have it. Council Lepala.
Move here from the director of the law commission.
Council Lepala makes a motion here from the director of the law commission, which you can, I think she's here tonight. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
The ayes have it. Welcome. Come on, please approach. Welcome back to the chamber in person. It was in the mask. We'll see how long this lasts. Welcome. No, we're okay. I'm not recording. Council Lepala.
Thank you for being here this evening. So this is, I think I like this all. Some really good, some concerning, some confusing. But let's try to figure it all out. First, if you got us this letter, thank you. Do you want to just speak to that quickly?
Sure.
And then we can kind of go from there.
We were just trying to find the most economical way to get to the EDC card and the easiest. And that's what we came up with. It's important to us that we are conservative with the funds that we manage because we're managing the subscriber funding. So we always try to look for the easiest and the cheapest way to go.
What's the money?
It is.
So, what we don't have here, but we talked about, and I just kind of asked you, the upgrading of the server is something you and Justin had kind of spoken in depth to. And there wasn't a number on that, on the sheet. Do you have a number? What?
Well, it's, you know, we put on that, you know, the upgrades and the staffing. This is what we estimate. Just to upgrade, because we need more space to run more information on our server. We're constantly becoming a little bit more information. So we try to save the meetings as long as we possibly can so that people in the community can watch them. So we try to keep them up for 3 to 6 months if we can. So if we're going to be doing that, we need more space on the server.
And I'm just scanning the letter quickly. So, okay, here we go. So the 20,000 is separately, that's needed
yes.
to get the equipment to be able
the
to 20, do the closed captioning.
The 20,000 would be for the closed captioning and the cost of captioning the meetings every time. But what we looked into is that most TVs, most cable companies already do that, so people have those TVs at home. So it would just be an extra thing that they have to do, but I'm pretty sure it's already done.
Would it, is it available via streaming, do you know? Is that? I know there are different questions and different concerns you know, getting them recorded. And from there, there are other things like the closed captioning and being able to participate, but I think first and foremost is getting them captured. From that, it looks like it's you get that 50,000. That's a rough estimate.
That's
yeah.
You know, if you weren't sure how many hours you needed Sunday for, and how many people you needed, so we just kind of guessed, you know.
Yeah.
We weren't really sure. And so, and then you upgrade it because the more information you put on the server, the bigger the server you need. And video files are very, very old.
Questions, but this time I'll look for floor and probably come back to me, but I know there are other counselors. I have no motion at this time.
Counselor? I'll just go
round up. I have two. One, is there three mentions? Is there a public or a free public source site? Like, can you put me on YouTube or something like that? Is that all that's allowed?
Well, I guess we could, but do you want that information out for anybody to grab and take a hold of? That's the question.
It's just, you know.
I mean, we could do that, but I mean, it's going on our playback system, so it's going to have to go on the server anyway.
It's just to acknowledge that, especially last year, there's a big call for transfers, and for me, if I didn't watch the calls, no, probably not. But there are people like, I think it's safe, it's there, I want to see it. Like, I want to have an option of seeing it. And I'm just trying to think of a cost effective way.
Well, we have to upgrade it on our playback system anyway in order for it to come on the channel.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So it's one thing. And if we had to do it on YouTube, it would be another thing.
So you have to have it recorded on before.
Right.
If you
so
do it there, you still have
it. We record it, it goes on to, it goes through the playback system.
Okay,
so yeah. then it can go onto our website and the city's website. The city also takes our fee. And there's a firewall issue and a few other things.
And just a follow up, I don't fully understand closed captioning. I know a lot of utilities need that. So for the most part, are you saying that you would be cost effective to get that like last inch basically?
We receive our funding through cable grants, right? So we get grants from RC and Comcast and Verizon. We don't get any taxpayer money at all. And people in the last 2 years have been cutting cable. And so the last 2 years we've gone down 10% each year. And then gas prices going up, the economy tanking. We're going to lose a lot of revenue next year. Pretty sure we are. So what we're trying to do is hold on to it as long as we can. The other issue we have is that Comcast and Verizon are going to the FCC to try and end cable access. And currently they're trying to put somebody on the FCC who doesn't believe in freedom of speech. So if Comcast and Verizon go to the FCC and say, well, you know, that's all about freedom of speech, I don't think she's going to vote for us. Okay? So, when that happens, Comcast and Verizon will take the channels back. There will be no cable channels left. And then the cable channels and the meetings will all have to go online. So we're just concerned about the future, and we're trying to take our funding and stretch it for as long as we possibly can.
Understood. I guess if it's already being covered, it's also covered. I think that's an acceptable agreement.
Thank you.
Thank you, Madam Chair. Through you, first and foremost, thank you for making it. It's safe to say that everyone here values the service you provide the city. And I think this was more a conversation around accessibility and transparency. It's not necessarily a dig at you have done. At least me personally, I think that's a terrible thing that the FCC is trying to do. But that's, I think, an existential threat, and we're not discussing that tonight. But I do appreciate your candor. That's important. So the way I'm understanding, there's like three components to this. There's like the video equipment, there's closed captioning, and that good news to you?
Well, it's fine news, it's just confusing, because I'm not a city department, I'm a nonprofit. So would I be supervising city employees? Would there be somebody in the city supervising them? That, you know, that's a little bit confusing for us. If something happens to the equipment and they're not an employee of the Waltham Community Access Corporation, when we have it insured and warranted, do we still get covered under the warranty? So there's like just a couple of questions we have about how that's going to work.
Yeah, I mean, I don't mean to speak on behalf of anyone here. I think the spirit is to work in coordination and cooperation. You know, we, at least I don't think from the sponsor of this resolution wanted to add any extra burden. I think if anything, we wanted to beef up our resources. And I just really wanted to part of that point about accessibility. A lot of folks were struggling to make it out here on Monday night to be physically present. So I think we want to work in coordination. I think that's what we want to do. So if we have the staff, and let's pretend we have a good system that we can transport the data, the video imaging to you so that that can be broadcasted, what else do you need on our end? What else can make this a more successful and logistically feasible thing?
I think that I need to sit down with some of you and really figure this out. I mean, can the staff at the Waltham Channel do this? How many hours a week do you need? That's, you know, it was kind of vague when I came in here with Justin last time about how much time it would take. And so I think, you know, I know that some of the meetings meet for, I just started meeting here, we met for 5 minutes, you know, that's 5 minutes, right? That wouldn't take much time to do for a staff person to come in and take a 5 minute meeting. So I think what I would like to do is just to sit down and talk about, can the Waltham Channel do this? Can we do this with our staff? Or do we really need to hire two more people to do this? Again, I'm just trying to save everybody some money, right? And try and get it done effectively and efficiently and make sure the quality is where it should be. You know, the staff of the Waltham Channel, they all have degrees in communications. If something breaks down, they know how to fix it. Would somebody who's here for 4 hours a week know how to do that? And then who's responsible for that? Is it me? Is it the staff? Is it the city? Who's responsible? Who's responsible if they don't show up? Maybe it's a kid who wants to go to the beach that day and he just doesn't show up. I mean, how does that? So that's why it's good for to have consistency. That's all. Does that make sense?
Yeah, I mean, yeah. I think you're being quite reasonable. I really appreciate that. Yeah, so what I'm hearing is that we may just need to, I'm assuming this would be under the auspices of our IT director, possibly. Maybe that's a question for HR. Through you to Councilor Mordecai?
No, I'm just as confused. I mean, the job posting was news to all of us. I think it was kind of out of the field. I made some phone calls last week to try to find out where it came from, what you know, what's behind it, and who the answer to, and don't really know. So I'm a little concerned as to the timing of it, why it came out as we're trying to get to the bottom of this. Maria's coming in tonight, she's coming in, and I'd like to get this resolved through the Waltham Channel. I don't know about going outside.
Whatever we can do to resolve this,
yeah.
So everybody's happy, right?
And so from the chair, reason why people want these shows to be taped. I mean, it's the bottom line. As far as the number of hours, we've got five committees. I'll name them: Economic and Community Development, Long-Term Debt, Licenses and Franchise, Public Works and Public Safety. Those four committees meet 21 times a year for no more than an hour. We have veterans, which meets four times a year for an hour. The total number of hours is 8 hours per year, plus or minus. So that's less than 2 hours per week. So if you need an estimate of the hours, and I'm assuming that someone that comes for a 5 minute meeting would be paid for at least an hour because they made the effort to show up. So it's 88 hours per year. That's it. And then related to that is my question: how much do you pay an operator to record for an hour? What's the going rate?
It depends on
how many staff's been in the
building,
who gets
salaries for staff.
Well, just give me a range.
I can't. Employee you're talking about. I mean, it's
just not average price if you hired someone.
Well, if we hired somebody off the street, I think the mayor has it right. It's about $25. That's what we pay the kids to do the concerts on the common.
So $25 per hour. So if we took 88, call it 100 just to even it out. 100 times 25 is what number?
$2,500.
$2,500 for the
record. That's what it would cost. That's it.
Without the server cost.
Yeah. Okay. So we're not talking about
that. That's just labor. Then there's the software.
Okay.
The right piece, which is really the storage and the time to actually build it. There's the labor cost.
I think we're the only city in Greater Boston that doesn't record the council meetings. I have to be frank,
I made a list of three cities, Cambridge, Somerville, and Newton, and the meetings they don't cover and the meetings they do cover. So if anybody would like to see that, I have that here.
From the chair, though, that was the committee scans in everybody's boxes, but if you want to do some.
We've been trying to get this done for 5 years ago, 5 or 6 years, and we made absolutely no headway. And I find it hard that you can hire people to go take ward neighborhood meetings, but you can't take the official meeting. Wait a minute, please let me finish. I find it difficult that you have resources to take ward neighborhood meetings, but you don't have the resources, you don't have the time to record official city council meetings. I mean, there's a disconnect.
Can I answer that? So that is one meeting, and that's 2 hours in a year, that somebody requested, and not only did somebody